Get the vehicle you want at The Car Company in Warsaw. You'll find more makes, models, colors, and styles of high-quality pre-owned cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs at half the price of new. And now your new full-line Suzuki dealership for motorcycles, ATVs, and scooters. The Car Company on US 30 East in Warsaw.
Lake City TV. Local. Dependable. On demand.
The storm that passed through Kosciuszko County early Tuesday morning did more than just tear up yards and cut off power. It claimed the life of a 14-year-old boy when a tree fell on a mobile home in Winona Lake. It happened at the Fairlane Mobile Home Park while the teenager was playing video games with a friend. The incident also injured three others, but they're all expected to be fine. Also in Kosciuszko County, it was a close call for a Syracuse man that had a tree land in front of his car while he was driving. He was treated for minor injuries and released from the hospital. If you're one of the thousands of people that lost power because of the weather, you may want to think about tossing the food in your fridge. The health department says any thawed food that got above 41 degrees and remained there for at least 4 hours should be thrown away. And representatives from the Indiana Department of Education say the Warsaw Community Schools summer school classes canceled yesterday because of the weather will not have to be made up. Summer school session one will wrap up today as scheduled. Session two runs from July 7th through the 29th. Looking at your Storm Team 16 forecast, partly sunny today, a high right around 70. Sunshine in lower 70s tomorrow and Friday for the 4th of July, sunshine and middle 70s. A young boy found dead in a Syracuse home likely died from carbon monoxide poisoning from breathing the exhaust of two generators in the home. The Syracuse Police Department says an autopsy showed the cause of death was consistent with carbon monoxide poisoning, but the final ruling will not be made until toxicology results are received. 12-year-old Skylar Spohr was found unresponsive and not breathing on Saturday. And an author from Mentone is celebrating the nationwide release of her new children's book called Clown for a Day. It's a story of a boy trying to fulfill his own little dream in his own little way. Michelle Holloway is a graduate of the Institute of Children's Literature and lives in Indiana with her husband and two children. From Lake City TV, I'm Terry Armstrong. Have a great afternoon.